It was a quiet night at Shadowfang Keep. I think we're going to change that right about now. Hi, it's Hobbs again. Welcome to my video. A lot of you have seen my other ones in the past, which are basically entitled How to Get Lots of Gold and Power Leveling in WoW. And in the past videos, I've explained what weapons I use, what gear, plus I have it on my website, the WoW blogs, wowhobbs.blogspot.com. What I'm going to do today is I'm going to explain more of the why, like why this is good for not only the person doing the pulling and power leveling the other character, but also for the person being power leveled. Lately, people have probably noticed in your realm that there's a lot of people willing to pay gold now to get runs, whether it be through Shadowfang, Dead Mines, Scarlet Monastery. On my server, I've been noticing a lot of people say, we'll pay 2 gold, we'll pay 4 gold, we'll pay 10 gold. Which is nice, because now a lot of the level 70s are working on their alts, and they give their alts 200-300 gold, and they want to get them up fast. The thing is for a player to not go to Outlands and to power level somebody for an hour or two, they will make more money in Outlands. So whether it be 2 gold, 4 gold, or something that you're offering, it's really not going to be profitable for the player. So what this is a way that you can get a level 60 or 70 to come with you. You're going to get great experience, and they're also going to get a lot of nice loot. Normally, how I set the loot rules up is if they need it, they roll need. If they don't, they basically they pass. The pass is the X in the top right-hand corner. What that will do is they will get all the gear that they need to wear, and you'll get all the stuff. If you have a couple priests or if you have a mage in the group, you'll get all the plate and the leather, which is nice. Because really, as a higher level, I'd love to see them have better gear. It's going to help them out. I ran a mage through the other day, and he got 3 blues. He got the belt of Argyll, the robe as well, and then the shoulders, and he also got a staff, and he gained a level and a half. So, you know, that's a really positive thing that he leveled. He got some good gear. Oddly enough, he was only level 18, so he won't be able to use it till later on. But the nice thing with that is he made money from all the gray drops, so instead of him having to spend 2 gold or 4 gold or 10 gold paying a higher level character, by introducing him to a theory like this, whether by showing him the video or a higher level character, mainly a pally, because that's what I know. I know pallies. For hunters and all the other classes, they'll have their own method of power leveling, but everybody can find a pally. There's a ton of them out there, even in the Horde realm now. So that was the first pull. So, getting back, what's really neat with this video is I got, if we take a look at this guy's experience bar, we actually he's about a bubble away right now from leveling, and so we're going to see it through his eyes, going to see the experience pop up on his screen, what the other player would see being power leveled, because all my other videos have been just through my eyes, which is quite it's quite interesting to watch for myself to see it from a different perspective, because I've always heard people gain lots of experience, but I've never actually got to see the experience pop up like this. This is actually Naxter. He took the video. Really smart guy. He has a level 70 hunter as well. But when I found him, we played together for a few nights, got him a few levels and lots of loot. The other nice thing is he has a website where he actually made the a forum for Wowhobbs. I actually have that link on my blog, so when you go there, check it out. He made me a chat master or whatever it is. I'm new to all that, so. But I've got my own forum now. So here you'll see all the purple coming up. And he's still a bar away from level. And there's still a lot of them living. This is actually the same poll we just watched, but from a different perspective. And bang, there he goes. He leveled. Which is nice. Of course, you're going to see him say ding. And you know, that's great, because when you're in a group and you do this, and sometimes we just pull this first pull over and over again, because it actually will get so much more experience, especially if we've ran it 3-4 times and he already has the blues. He's got the dagger out of here. He has the staff. He has the shield. And that's all within a few runs. So now we're kind of saying this is the best experience part. So why not run this over and over? So this is the second pull. If you remembered, I went up to right to the stairs. This one's quite interesting and fun. Lots of undead here. So back to the reasons why. A lot of the items that you get, you're going to find that you're going to have a full bag full of greens, full of wool, full of linen, full of cloth. And there's a lot of people saying, yeah, wool, linen, cloth, big deal. I can go farm netherweave cloth and get 4 gold or 5 or 6 depending on your server. But the thing is with this is it's a lot of small amounts. If you do this method, I suggest you do get the auctioneer program because you're going to be putting a ton of auctions up. I typically have 300 to 500 auctions up at any given time, and they just keep coming back, coming back. It's more like the vending machine theory where it's a lot of small sales, but they all add up. And I also grabbed the mail program lately because I was tired of clicking back and forth, back and forth. Plus it saves me a lot of time. I think it's called CT Mail Mod. So when you post all these, if you think 3 to 5 items, 100 items, and a lot of them are worth anywhere from 50 silver up to a dollar, or sorry, not a dollar, a gold, that's not a huge amount for somebody A to spend who just rolled their alt, their level 70, and they gave them 300 gold. They want to get up as fast as possible so they can start doing the bigger instances again. So a lot of that takes some money. And plus, a lot of them are rolling new. They need the wool. They need the linen. They need those just to get them up. So, you know, rather than go out and farm it, why not just buy it? They've got the gold from their main. So that's why you're always going to find a market for this type of stuff. And like I say, if you have a guild or if you're part of a guild or your friend just joined, this is a nice way of getting them to your level fast. I'm going to actually show, after this, we're going to show another older pull as well, which is really neat. Naxxer actually took a great video of just turn it around it, and it's quite impressive, like I say again, to see it from somebody else's point of view, because I've been doing this for probably 2 years, and I've always had a ton of money. I've always had 16 slot bags. I got my purple tiger from Darnassus, which halfway through I thought I wanted to give up because I spent probably 2,000 gold in rune cloth, but you know, once you were halfway, you had to do it. It was like either A, it was a waste of money, or B, you wanted it. But I did like the tiger, so I ended up getting it. I just want to thank people, too, for all the subscribers, too, on YouTube. If you want to subscribe to this, because I'm going to have more videos out of different instances, also different methods you can make money if you are low on funds, it's a great way to do it. The other, just hit the subscribe in the top right-hand corner when you're done this, or if you want to add it to your favorites. Leave me a comment. Let me know what you like best about this video, or what you'd like to see different in the future, because I always appreciate the positive comments. It's really kept me going, making more of them. And now that I have an apprentice making videos, it's actually quite fun to see it from two different angles. As he levels, we'll get more and more different videos. So there we go. This is the last pull again. So drop by the blog, do some reading, leave me some comments, and looking forward to seeing you on the next one. I've actually got about 3 videos on my computer right now that I'm just in process of tweaking and editing and making up the commentaries for it. So lastly, signing off, 3 quick points. If you're a guild master and you have a website, look to the right. There's a link you can use to link it to this to this video, or you can embed it right on your web page. Secondly, if you do go to Naxxer's chat page, we got a couple bonus videos there for you in his website as well that's not posted here. And check out my videos in Scarlet Monastery and Alderman by clicking on other videos from this user. And it's all about the Hobbs way of pulling.